With so many platforms from YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and more, it can be difficult to plan all of your content consistently. In this video, we wanted to show you step by step how to create a simple content planner with Notion. We also use Notion for our own content planning, and it has been a huge game changer. If you find this useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start by opening an empty Notion page, and we're going to call this Content Planner. And we can also choose an icon already by clicking add icon, and we'll go to icons and let's choose something like this computer window. And you can also add a cover photo if you wish. Then let's also go to the top right hand corner, three dots, and turn on small text full width. And this way we have more space on the page. So the next step is going to be to build the databases that are going to be a part of this content planner. And in this case, we're going to be having two databases. So first we're going to type slash callout, and we're going to put the databases inside of this callout box just so that we make sure not to delete it. So we're going to title this databases, and let's go ahead and also bold this. Let's type shift enter, and we're going to add a new page by typing slash page. So the first database we're going to be adding is going to be our publishing calendar. So anything that you're going to be posting is going to go inside here. And we can go ahead and click the more button here to create a calendar view database inside of here and plus new database. So now we have our publishing calendar here, and we can also choose an icon, add icon, go to icons, and let's go ahead and choose something relating to a calendar. So now we're going to start also adjusting this calendar a bit so that we can immediately use it as a linked view database. So let's first just pretend to add an item inside of the publishing calendar. So let's say that you have a Instagram post that you're working on, and you're going to publish that on April 17th. So the first thing you're going to want inside of here is going to be what platform it is. So let's go ahead and change this tag, rename, and we're going to call this platforms. So here we can put Instagram, we can put Facebook, we can put YouTube. So basically anything that you post on, you can just add here. So it could be your blog and so on. So we're going to just change all the colors to match. So once you have a couple of these, obviously with this one, it's going to be Instagram. So we can just choose the Instagram option. And sometimes you might want to cross post. So in that case, you could even add two things at the same place. So after we have this, the other thing you might want to add is the status. So you want to know where you are with this post. So this we're going to add as a select property, and we're going to call this status. So the statuses can be different for everyone, but we're going to be adding not started. Then we're also going to add an option that's in progress, and we're going to add scheduled. So sometimes you might just schedule a post and then published. So these are going to be our different statuses, and let's go ahead and also change the color a bit. So if it's in progress, maybe blue, and scheduled could be green, and published could be yellow. So this you can just choose your own colors. And let's say this is not started for us. And then you might also want to add a link property in case that you want to add the URL to it at the end. So we're going to add URL like this. And finally, later, we are going to connect this to the other database, which is going to be for your tasks. So for now, this looks really good. So we're going to click out and see how it looks. So now you can see that none of the properties are showing. So we have to go to the three dots here and then turn on the properties. So we want to see the platform, we want to see the status, and maybe the URL, there's no need to actually see it. So we're just going to keep it like this. The other thing we're going to be doing is just to go to layout and turn off show page icon. So this way we're not going to see the icon next to the title. And then we can go back to our content planner. So the first database is now done. So we're going to create our next one by clicking the plus sign here and slash page again. And this one's going to be called tasks. And here we're going to opt for a board view database and plus new database. And we're going to also choose an icon, add icon, and let's go with a checkbox here like this. And now let's also add some cards that might be relevant for this Instagram post. So usually you might want to prep the images first. So prep in Canva the carousel for the Instagram post. And you might want to keep the assign because sometimes you're working with multiple people. So this is really useful if you're doing that. So you can actually just add someone there. The other thing you might want to add would be a due date in case that you want to organize your task list based on date. So let's go ahead and add a date property and we're going to just call it due date. So let's say that this is due on the 18th. And then finally, we're going to also relate this database to the publishing schedule. So we're going to add a relation. And this is going to be relating to the publishing calendar. And we're going to show on publishing calendar add relation. So now what you can do is choose the Instagram post that we were planning in our publishing calendar and connect it there. And after that, we can click here and turn on the properties. So we want to see the due date. We want to see the publishing calendar, and the status is quite obvious from this view, so we're not going to show that here. So now let's go ahead and delete these other extra cards that have been created here, and we can go back. So now let's go ahead and add linked views inside of our main dashboard. So here we're going to type /heading 3 and add the publishing calendar and /divider. And /linked view of database, and we're going to choose the publishing calendar here. Make sure to choose the correct database, and we already have a calendar view, and you can see what it looks like here. So we have that Instagram post. Now we're also going to hide the database title so it looks a little bit cleaner. And as you can see, a linked view basically just shows the same view as the main database, but anything you change here is also going to be reflected in the main database. So under here, we're going to add our task. So /heading 3, and let's go ahead and add our task /divider. And here we're going to add again /linked view of database and choose the tasks. And we can select the board view. And again, we can hide this database title. So now what we're going to be doing is to create a database template inside of our publishing calendar so that we can actually see all of our tasks relating to that post. So if we open this up, it would be nice to actually see the tasks relating inside of here. To do that, we're going to be going to this blue button arrow here plus new template, and here we'll put new publishing post. And we're going to put the status already as not started. So every time you add a new publishing post, it's going to start with not started. And the task we're actually going to now show as minimal so that we don't directly see them here. And after that, you can kind of customize what you need here. So for example, you can add /heading 3 notes here. So maybe you want to add your caption inside of here, /heading 3. You could put caption /divider and /heading 3. You can add also files divider, and inside you could do /embed and just embed the file in here. So these are all optional if you need the same format every time. And then finally, we could add the linked view of database, and we can add the task database here. So let's go ahead and open this up in full page so we can see it a little bit clearer. Select the data source, and we're going to go with the tasks here and choose board view and hide database title. So this is just showing everything you have in this board view, but what we want to do is filter it by this new publishing post. So we're going to go ahead and click filter. Filter it by publishing calendar, new publishing post, save for everyone. And we can also go ahead and sort the due date by ascending, save for everyone. So now if we go back, it should be okay here. And let's actually also add a heading. So /heading 3, and we'll call this task slash divider. So now we have a database template. And if we go back and let's say we click open this Instagram post, the new publishing post, it's going to load everything in here with the notes, caption, files, and tasks. So let's say that you have further tasks, like the next thing you're going to do is prepare the caption, and you can assign it, you can add a due date, and everything is tagged with this Instagram post. So if we click out, you can also see it in the main view as well. So this is useful if you have multiple publishing posts at the same time, but you want to keep track of all your tasks relating to that. It can be a really great way to add. And finally, the other thing we wanted to show you is that you can really customize this. So this is just the Instagram post, but let's say that we're also going to be publishing YouTube video here. And you want a specific template for that. So we're going to choose YouTube. The status would be not started, and we click out. So ideally we would want a template for that. So we're going to actually duplicate this one and we'll call this YouTube template. So every time you have a YouTube publishing schedule, you can already pre-fill in YouTube, pre-fill in status, and I guess URL you wouldn't want to fill yet. And then let's say that instead of caption, you want the description here, and you might want some tags. So slash heading 3 tags slash divider, and you could add your tags in here if you need, and so on. So you can really customize it to your own needs. You might even want to put a description that you can copy paste for every video inside here that you can edit every time. So those are all really great options. If we go back and we go ahead and open this up and choose the YouTube template, it's going to automatically load all of the template information that you added here. So you could do the same, you could duplicate this one and next make, let's say, a Facebook post template and so on. And for Instagram, it's useful if you add hashtags. So this is all ways that we would recommend you to customize this. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in downloading the template that we built in this video, the link is in the description. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.